What is up, everybody? This is Cowboy again from Team Fuel Gaming. And, I forgot what I was doing. I went to go get another cup of coffee and I've just had a brain fart. Oh, yeah, I'm gonna take these people back. Dun-la, dun-la, dun-la. Oh my goodness, there's zombies everywhere. Well, there used to be. Wow, there is a lot of zombies down here. That's fairly unnerving. Be right down the road from your house. Be like them neighbors that you never quite get along with. Okay. Now, I know... Okay. Did I park that there? No, I did not. This truck keeps on changing sides. It's blowing my mind. Okay. They made it back from the construction run, so that's pretty cool. I got my bunk up, so... Then we got 12 beds... Wait. Population 12, beds 8. And the bunkhouse is already up, really? Needs a workshop. Okay, so when that completes, we'll be good to go. That's bad. But I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of it. Don't need that. Snitches get snitches. Oh. For some reason, it didn't look like there was glass there. I don't know what I was even thinking. Okay, this truck's in rust shape. We may need to... we may need to swap out here. Probably... Within the next couple of episodes, I'm gonna do some kind of Xbox Live commentary co-op. One of my buddies is gonna download this. He said he'd like to try it out, so I'm gonna walk him through how to do a couple things. And I am gonna go ahead and do this mission.
Don't come driving up like a dumbass.
Sorry, hurry up.
What Alan's trying to say is cars make noise.
Oh my goodness. Sorry, hurry up and get out of this town. That seems to be overpopulated with zombies. I'm telling you, I don't know what it is, but it seems like I have had more luck finding good weapons in houses than I have the gun shops and stuff here lately. So this mission ain't hard. The only hard one.
Let's get this show on the road.
Gosh, look at that dog's eyes. That's creepy. But the only hard mission here is the Wilkerson, I think that's their names. But this farm, right? Yeah. Is this it? Yeah. This back here. Where you gotta defend to get Doc Watson or whatever out of there. That's hard. That's pretty hard. Did you hear that? I'm not saying. Pretty good suppressor on you. There we go. Kinda wanna search around here. Hey, there's a supply shed. Whoops. Ah. Yes. So we're gonna go ahead and search this joint here. Thank you, Alan. You will get tired of Alan really, really quick. He's nothing but a troublemaker, so... Shoot, even the back door's locked. Come on in, boys and girls. Come on in.
All right, hop to it. Let's get this done and get the hell out.
So we killed some zombies that was lurking right outside the base, so we shouldn't have too much trouble to right at the beginning, but it'll probably be pretty overwhelming here in just a second. I'm still the only law enforcement. Here they coming. Oh, they can't get through that window unless they're like an NBA star.
Goddamn motherfucking piece of shit. What's wrong?
Whoa. I'm just gonna kinda. They're trying to bust into the storage unit. I knew that thing had a door on it, I just couldn't figure out where exactly. Oh. I have a habit of just leaving my light on. Sorry about that, if that bothers anybody.
Finish it off.
Gather your stuff. Oh, that was terrible. I don't want to leave my truck out here. But I guess I got to right now. We're going to go ahead and clear out this building here. Because I'm going to stay up here for a little bit. Make sure I search everything. So I'm going to go ahead and
better look around.
Probably upgrade my workshop.
We've got this place locked down.
Because if I'm not mistaken, your workshop has to be upgraded. Your workshop has to be upgraded to fix vehicles overnight, I think. I don't look at that. Let's see. Automatically? Yeah, I think you do have to do it. No. That's a different thing. Let me see here. Parking space. Auto repair. Cars left overnight. Will be repaired a bit. Requires workshop. Okay. And then if you upgrade the workshop, I think that repairs is even more dramatic. Even better. So, I wish I had some more bullets down through here. Now would be a good time to level up my rifle skill on the way back to the camp since we cannot get in a vehicle. Alan, get on my nerves, and you're not even a real person. One time I got stuck on that guardrail. I don't know if it was that one, but I got stuck on a guardrail because the zombie's on the other side, and I was going to try to reach across, and I couldn't hit him, but he bit me, and somehow I got inside of it. It took me like 2 minutes to get out of it. So we have. Yeah, I need to go get ammo. And I probably need to go and get some medicine, a rucksack of medicine from somewhere.
I'll go find us a ride.
No, goddammit. Cars are too dangerous. Just leave it.
Kiss my ass, Alan. Really need these meds.
Fuck you.
Whoa.
Get your ass back here, Alan. Alan! God damn it. Come on, let's find a ride and get the shit home.
Alan is a douchebag. She's just gonna stand there, really? Okay. Well, I probably shouldn't have put that rucksack on right now, but hopefully we can slip up under. Up, 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 up. Hopefully we can slip up here to unnoticed. Oh no, and then it begins. Shoot, I don't know what it is. Like, I haven't taken allergy medicine since I was a little kid because, you know, it just, I kept on forgetting it, and then, you know, I'd go cut hay and bush hog and all that stuff and come home, just take a shower and be just fine, but this year, like, the pollen in Kentucky's just been terrible, and it's just playing dirty tricks on me.
Thanks for the ride.
You're welcome, buddy. Kind of hope Alan got 8 on the way up here. He's one character that I don't mind losing. Holy crap, I have 37 resources already. When I get ammo, yeah.
We got your cycle for phosphamide, Lily. I didn't see you.
Hey, you said we were getting antibiotics for A.
Boldface liar.
What the hell is going on here?
Come on, come on, watch. Your friend needs antibiotics. Oh. You're the one that's talking, okay.
Sent you to a place you might find.
Who's that, dude?
So, you used me.
I didn't.
Just let me know when you find the doc.
That's the dude. No, this is the dude. He's pretty cool. My buddy said that they'll actually take. That's a pretty good rifle, 700. My buddy said that they'll actually take guns out of the stash. Okay, let me see. Let me check on my camp here. Okay, workshop, if I upgrade, automatically repair body and tire damage for vehicles parked over 9. Okay, so that's gonna take a little bit. Do we need to get another? Oh gosh, yeah. We need to get some more beds. A going. Okay, let me see. This construction site right up here has probably got several in it. Oh, I know what I need to do before I do anything. Reload my stuff. And how many shots do I got? Like 3 on the suppressor. Alright. Let's do this. I should have built some suppressors before I actually did that. That's okay. Maybe we won't hit too much opposition up here. Hopefully. I hear a zombie. He hates me. Why do you... I'm grizzly. You don't want me. I hear something.
Sit tight. I'm bringing
very
stuff
angry.
Home.
We'll be ready.
We've got this place locked down.
Is that a feral? I keep on thinking I hear a feral, but he's nowhere to be seen, so maybe I'm just freaking out for no reason. That clip was a little bit big. Oh, it's a screamer, that's what it was. I knew I heard something different than normal. I'll bring these supplies back to y'all.
Okay, I'm free and clear.
Should be able to.
I hope you brought me something pretty.
I'll show you when I get
level up something. But I haven't found any bladed weapons yet. So that may be a little bit flawed. looking for bigger bladed weapons. Let's see. Good quality, well maintenance blade. That's probably a good trade. If I can do it. So, stats here. Yeah. Chance to decapitate, so. And I've got a bunch of stuff I can choose from, actually. We're gonna go ahead and do this. And, I like this one. Kill two nearby enemies. I like that one. And then I think the next level up notch, I can do the one where I can quick quiet search or something else. Oh yeah, I need to get that bladed weapon.
Hello, Sam.
Well, that's mean. The guy's just trying to do his job. Not be okay. Well, I mean, we're not critically low. No, we're not low at all. We're actually at the, above the max, if I... Yeah, we got 28 medicine, so we're good there. Go ahead and upgrade this. We got the workshop upgrading. We could do with another outpost. I definitely need to get an outpost closer to the house. Maybe a survivor or a Zed hunt or something will pop up and I can have some help here before too long. You are trying to enter in a house forcefully. I'm thinking about this house right here. It'd be probably a pretty good spot. What outpost does, if you know, I heard a lot of people was confused on exactly what they did. Each outpost you have actually, let me go to it, a 15% chance the missing ally is coming home safely. As long as they have somewhere to duck in their path, it's going to be safe, which once you create an outpost, zombies can't spawn inside of it. So that's really useful because you don't have to go on, find people in trouble missions that often, you know? Because that happens to me a lot. I will send somebody out for resources, just, you know, kind of expect them to do their job, and then bada bing, bada boom, I'm halfway across town, and then they're trapped in the middle, you know? So. Search everything in here real quick. I don't need any food. Hopefully we can find another rifle. I wouldn't care to have I wouldn't care to have a 700 or something pop up. Holy crap. A lot of zombies around my car. Just kind of dusting them out over there. Stand right there. There you go. Alright, so my exit's cleared. Every single time, it seems like if I go in a house, you know, everything's going good. I'm searching through stuff okay. I'm like, no way. You know, no zombies is... gonna try to intervene in this? That's weird. Now I'll go outside, and there will be, like, a mosh pit threatening to flip over my car. I never really use
you've got this place locked
alarm clocks or timers or anything like that. I usually just turn them in for the influence points.
Not now.
I did fully search it. Oh, fully search it. I may have left something. Did I go in here? I went in here, right? Okay. We got this little cabinet here to search, and then we'll have an outpost right out from our main base. Wow.
Wouldn't be a bad idea to set up here.
Pretty big stuff. Sure you want to go through with this?
So we got a food.
Let's do this.
If I'm remembering right, we got a food, a resource, and an ammo. And them little buildings, these storage sheds right here, these right here usually have not only your survivors in most missions, but also have a lot of building materials and resources, so that may be something to keep your eye out for. I don't know if I want to waste. Yeah, we're going to go on down here. Set up another ammo reinforcer. Oops. Come on out, y'all. Maybe it'll just let me walk up in here and claim it. No, it's gonna make me research it. And I gotta go upstairs too, so.
Something's still moving around.
Oh, gosh.
Looks like a good spot.
Oh, it let me set it up. Okay, cool.
Tell everyone to pack up?
Let's make this outpost happen.
Okay, so I pretty much got everything covered with them outposts besides out here, which I'm not really too concerned on anything out there. Okay. Oh, snap. I almost started the party early. One down. Stand still, sir. I'm gonna need you to die. Is there a zombie right behind me? Is he up here with me? No, he's downstairs. Okay, I'm just shooting the rail. Here comes a huge zombie horde up the road. That ain't good. This guy's got the pimp swagger going on. So I'm gonna non-discreetly just drop down right here. Come on. Come on. Come on. There you go. Instant decapitate. I like it. Okay. Oh, the zombie horde turned. I was about to say, if they come... Well, they may get hit by a trap regardless, so that's pretty good.
I recorded it a little while ago.
If you're hearing this, we could use some help.
Okay.
Sounds like they're in a bad spot.
Mark it.
I want to offer them a hand. You'll find it on your map.
Okay. Safe hunt. Okay. Good, good.
I'll check this out next.
The only thing about it, Zed Hunt, is like I said, I usually like to take. I like to take, you know, somebody out with me. And, usually wreck a couple of houses before I actually do the objective. Zed hunts have a limited area
over here
in which you can
lead the way.
Take the people outside of. So, but in this game, there's so many little houses and things usually.
Found some supplies.
Usually it ain't no big deal to do so. It ain't no big deal to search a couple of houses in your perimeter. And it's a pretty big ring, so you can take them out.
Nice.
Come on, gun. I know people keep guns in their storage sheds. Come on. Alright, I probably keep them bladed weapons on him. I'm gonna go on in here. Search this house real good. Goodness gracious. 5 drawers. 5 big drawers. Gotta be something. Junk, of course. Cool. Usually, like, I will find random pretty good pistols in bedroom dresser drawers, which is really cool, and then these usually hold Molotov cocktails. So, now of course, fridges will usually have food and things. These come in pretty
Where
handy.
The hell am I gonna carry this?
But if you're in a rough situation, you know, it helps knowing what would hold what, just in case you're just searching one thing and you're having to get out of there. Well, you're going to try to search the thing that you know has a weapon in it or definite resources. Starting to get kind of dusky outside. Still got the living room here. Oh. This house had a lot of stuff in it. Not usable stuff, but just a lot of stuff to search. 40 cal. Okay. We will go ahead and take this coffee, refill our stamina. Got that 40 cal now. I don't know. In here, maybe? No.
All quiet here.
I think this is the last thing to search inside this house here. Every time, my dog's so funny. Every single time I look back, she's in a different spot on my bed. Okay, so we got that house fully searched. Let's go ahead and do one of these that they think that the feral's in. I'm guessing that that's what I'm doing this for, is a feral. I don't think he'd be in here, though. And I've never seen him in here. I've never seen anything in here, actually. So we're going to go ahead and clear this. Just to be a huge fast food restaurant, there probably isn't that much stuff in here. Everybody keeps pistols in their work locker at fast food restaurants, I bet. Got another bump to whiz, so that's pretty cool. Does it want me to search that? Big old cola. Yum, yum. Okay. He did tell me to come in here.
Consider this research.
There we go. I don't think he's in the bathroom. I think he's in one of these houses here. At least that's what I'm hoping. The lucky ones, you can actually see from a window or something.
Coming home now.
And you can just pop their heads off from a distance, which is awesome.
Where the hell am I gonna carry this?
One bullet? Well, a 22 shell, all you had to do was stick it in your pocket, behind your ear. Wearing a dress shirt, I know you got shirt pockets. Ooh, I need this.
I'll run this off.
I don't know why I picked that up like it was a rare commodity. I'm actually over full on medicine right now. Another 1911. Go ahead and use our pills. Because I was low on health anyway. Okay, another alarm clock. Okay. I'm just guessing that this feral zombie's gonna be in this last house over here.
Time to move on.
I don't think he would be in I do not think that he would be in the bathroom for some reason. Usually you can hear them pretty good because feral zombies make some nasty noise. Huh. I hear zombies. Well. Now, I leveled this guy up on bladed weapons. I forgot what the buff was if you level him up on guns. But, you know, usually you shoot him in the head and it's just one shot anyway, so I really don't see no... Please get out of the doorway. But anyway, I really don't see a reason to level somebody up in guns, because in a sticky situation, unless you have a shotgun, which I don't usually pack around, unless you are dealing with a shotgun, you're probably going to enter into melee combat in sticky situations. So I always figure it's best to put your it's kind of like a buff or whatever you use the most on a melee weapon, whether it be blunt, heavy, sharp. Really? This? No. I forget to search something downstairs, what it was, I guess. Yeah. So this house is holding a little bit of food. Need my Twinkie, or my snowballs. This over here, and I believe we're done with this house. So, in fact, the very place where I did not think the feral zombie was, is actually the very place he is. So, we'll go check this out. Any zombies around here? No? Uh-oh. Here we go. Oh, wait. Isn't there a front door to this place? Huh. Well. I'm fairly confused here. I may have walked right beside him and not even noticed. He may be outside around the house. I could be way the hell over here where I've neglected to search on accident. So I was right. He was not in the bathroom.
Trouble on the right flank.
Still got my good old homemade silencer. So I ain't scared. Watch my stamina a little bit. I picked up this rucksack and I don't want to really drop it. There he is. He's angry. I'm gonna.
Come on then, you think you're hard enough?
Yeah. Oh, whenever I'm helping people for feral hunts, I usually use them as a blocker. Now I'm friends with Felix. Alright. Go back home. Turn in this rucksack and yes. Oops. Fat zombies and rotters and SWAT zombies, all of them can definitely be found.
That's not good.
Are they gonna chase me up this road? Feral and fat and rotters and SWAT zombies can be found anytime, anywhere, screamers, so you gotta kinda be careful. Now would be a good time to level up my gun skills a little bit. I don't want a bunch of zombies coming up through here, really. The controls on here is a little bit touchy. Well, crap. Okay. Come on. I heard that explosion again. And them zombies did too, I believe. I don't know what that is that I keep on hearing, but I don't remember hearing that in other games. It's like a giant explosion. We're probably getting about to where I need to switch to a different character, but that's okay.
Found this while I was out.
Got 40 and a 45, 1911. 45 caliber royalty. That's exactly right. I got a crap ton of influence, so I'll go ahead and put that back in here. Yeah. Now would be a good time to
You think it's an evac route?
Switch characters.
Weird.
Because you want somebody with army experience to go down there, and that's exactly who she is, the army person. Okay, let me see. What do I want her to be? I know what I want her to have. She needs a silencer on that bad boy. We have 8 silencers. Oh, okay. Might do a little bit of leveling up with her while we're out. I heard that explosion again. Maybe that's the army down there shooting things.
I'm headed out.
Okay. Watch yourself out there.
Excuse me. Go down here and talk to these people.
Corporal Torres.
Sergeant Tan.
It's been a while.
Sergeant Tan.
Where was it?
3 years? Wildest guy ever. His name's Tan.
Right. Guess I'm not surprised you're out here ignoring the quarantine orders.
Yeah? Gotta say I'm surprised to see you standing around with your thumb up your ass while civilians are dying all around you.
You don't have to like orders to follow them.
So what? We're on our own?
There's a lonely little fat zombie up there. He's like, I just wanted a Big Mac.
Until the squids figure out what's causing
it, they're all potential carriers.
Any chance of you listening if I tell you to go home and lock the doors?
Probably not.
Of course.
No.
Well, then I guess I didn't see you out here. You better get going. Captain gets cranky when people contaminate her scene.
Leave the area.
So, when are they coming to get us?
They're not. We're on our own.
What?
Fuck it. We've survived this long. We'll keep surviving.
Okay. So we got that done. We're nearing the Watson, Doc Watson rescue mission. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut this off. It's been 40 something minutes. Thank you guys for watching. This has been Cowboy from Team Fuel Gaming. See you guys later.